One of the main things that distinguishes architectural drawings from any other drawings is that architects draw to convey information. In theory, architects can graphically describe any idea or object in enough detail that would allow builders to look at that drawing and then build that idea or object accurately without ever speaking to the architect. This means that architectural drawings need to be descriptive, complete, and organized. My name is Anna, I'm an architect, and today I'm going to show you how architects can describe anything in a complete and organized way, and how you can use the same tools to convey information about any object graphically.
Let's start with the very important concept that all drawings can be divided into two groups, 2D and 3D. 2D drawings represent two dimensions. 3D drawings add depth to the two dimensions to create a more immersive and realistic representation. 3D drawings can in turn be divided into 3D parallel projections, where all lines that are parallel to each other in an object are drawn parallel, and perspectives, the most realistic and familiar representation, because our eyes see things in perspective. All 3D drawings are a topic for a different video. What we care about here is that 3D drawings require much more time and energy to draw than 2D drawings. Architects sometimes end up making 3D drawings, but very sparingly and strategically. For example, architects make 3D renderings to sell a concept to a client, 3D diagrams to illustrate an idea in a presentation, or 3D sketches to describe something very complex. All of those take a lot of time and often cost a lot of money, and they comprise a small proportion of all drawings that architects create. When you hear architectural drawings, you probably think about 2D drawings. They are much faster and easier to create, and they're perfect for communicating information about any object if you use them systematically. There are three main types of drawings here: plans, elevations, and sections. Let's start with a plan. A plan is a view of an object directly from the top. I'm going to use this cute little box as an example. The plan view of this box would be this. If we wanted to draw this box in plan, we would draw exactly what we see: the top of the lid and the top of the clasp on the side. The second type of 2D drawings is elevation. An elevation is a view of an object from the side. This box has four sides, so it has four elevations. Let's draw the elevation of this box. This would be the drawing of the front elevation. Now let's draw a side elevation. Now a back elevation. And finally, the other side. I'm rotating the sheet because I want to show that each elevation is related to one side of a plan. But while the plan can be rotated, elevations always have a top and a bottom, so it makes more sense to display them this way, side by side, in order of rotation. So far, we've been looking only at the outside of this box, but it also has an inside. So how do we describe what's on the inside? We use the third main type of architectural 2D drawings, a section. This type takes a little imagination. Imagine that I take a knife and cut this box along this line, and look at the cut from the front. What I see is the section of the box. Try to visualize it in your mind. Now let me draw it and you can test yourself. This is what a section of this box looks like. Note that now you can see the thickness of the cardboard. And also now you know that there is, in fact, a radish inside. You would never have known that there was something in the box if you didn't see the section. This section is cut parallel to the long side of the box. The fancy name for this section is longitudinal. But we can also cut the box in the other direction, perpendicular to the long side. This section would be called transverse. And would look like this. Sections like elevations have tops and bottoms and should be displayed in the correct orientation. Using these three main types of 2D drawings, you can now describe any object graphically. Now let me show you how these drawing types apply to drawing architecture specifically. It sometimes happens that architects draw plans, sections, and elevations of existing buildings, like I did in the video where I drew the Pantheon. But more often, architects draw buildings that exist only in their brains, that are not constructed yet, and use plans, sections, and elevations as tools to help them design. So let's design and document something with the information that we just learned. We're going to design a tiny little house. Most of the time, you start designing a building with a plan. Do you remember how I told you that a plan is a top view of an object? The top view of a house would show you only the roof. That plan would be called a roof plan. Roof plans are helpful, but they don't show what's happening inside the house. That's where floor plans come in handy. A floor plan is a top view of a building with a roof removed. This is where it may get a little confusing, but a floor plan is really a horizontal section of the house. The floor plan shows the relationship between rooms, interior elements like furniture and equipment, and helps you visualize how people occupy the space. In architecture, the horizontal cut usually happens at exactly 4 feet from the floor. Why 4 feet? That's because most windowsills are at about 3 feet. And also the majority of furniture, like built-in counters, tables, beds, etc., are lower than 4 feet. So by cutting at 4 feet, you make sure that the plan shows the most information. So this is the plan of our little house. It has a living room, a bedroom, a bathroom, 3 doors, and 2 windows. Unlike my little black box that can be rotated however I want, a building is either attached or will be attached to the ground. So it should normally be oriented with the north direction, pointing up. Now let's design the elevations. The building won't have a front, back, and side elevations. It will have a north, south, east, and west elevations instead. Since we've already drawn the plan, we already know where the exterior doors and windows will be. Our house will have a single level, so once we get to the height of a ceiling at about 9 feet, we'll just draw a roof. It will have a regular gable roof. And let's cover the exterior walls with horizontal wood cladding, for example. The south elevation is done. Let's try drawing the rest of the elevations without rotating the sheet. The east elevation is going to look like this. We can decide what material the roof is going to be. Let's say metal standing seam panels. Now let's draw the north elevation. And finally, the west elevation. They look great. Now let's draw a couple of sections. The longitudinal section will cut through the living room and the bedroom. Normally, when you cut a section, you focus only on the elements that are being cut. It's not common to draw anything beyond the cut. For example, you wouldn't draw this bathroom door. If you do it, it becomes a section elevation and may get a bit confusing. But some people like section elevations. Let's say that there is a ceiling in the bedroom. But in the living room, the ceiling will be the underside of the roof. Is there a ceiling in the bathroom? We don't know until we draw a section through the bathroom as well. So let's cut one more section, this time to make sure we're cutting through the bathroom. Notice that you can show your section cut not only on the plan, but also on the elevations. So that's it. We have a concept of a house. Hope you had fun. Thank you for watching. Bye.